1223 here on this Monday across the valley. A hot Monday around the area. Heat advisory in effect this afternoon. Kicks off at 1 o'clock for not quite everywhere. Not Starr County, not right along the coast and eastern edges of Willacy and Cameron counties. But, you know, it's not like you can jump across the border and all of a sudden it's like, ah, refreshing. It's basically hot all over. But the heat index up around 110 or maybe a little hotter at times. Been a pretty hot August so far. A number of 100-degree days in McAllen continue to count up. We're at 17 out of the first 18. You add in what will likely be today. That could be 18 out of the first 19. The average since 1970 going back farther is only about 12, but a lot of that happened before about the last 10 years. Since the last 10 years, we've been averaging about 23 days, almost double the amount of 100-degree days in McAllen as before. So, yeah, going to be hot, and even Brownsville hasn't had too many 100-degree days, but the average temperature could be on pace for a monthly record in Brownsville here by the end of the month. So we'll wait and see. But heat advisory today, near 100 degrees in many areas, especially the upper valley, could exceed 100 degrees. Small rain chance today. I mean, very small. There's a couple of little tiny, tiny showers that briefly pop up for like 10 minutes or so on the radar, but nothing that's big out there. But could gradually shift later this week, maybe a few more showers and storms in the afternoon hours by the weekend. Right now it's 95 in Rio Grande City, or Raymondville, the other R town. 95 in Raymondville, 95 in Rio Grande City. Oh, it was 95 in Rio Grande City. I guess my mind was subconsciously thinking that. I don't know. Didn't get enough sleep. 95 in Harlingen, 96 in Brownsville. Feels like, though, over 100. 109, heat index in Brownsville. 105 in Rio Grande City, 104 in Raymondville, and probably will hit about 110 or hotter this afternoon. At least there is a breeze. The gust right now about 20 to 29 miles per hour or so, give or take a little bit across the valley. A little breeze from the south and southeast, but blowing in more heat and humidity. The sea breeze not able to spark much yet, kind of what's left of it coming westward across the area. But once in a while, a little shower tries to pop up. Most of them are up in Kennedy County now and right on the edge of Willacy County, but this is all passing north of us. But as the instability comes around this afternoon, you might see a couple of these little small showers or a flash of lightning if something really gets going today. But likely not much. Yeah, if you do get a shower, maybe like a 5 or 10 minute shower or so this afternoon. Future track shows almost nothing now. It just kind of shows a few clouds at times. But mostly sunny skies, likely in many areas much of the day. And by this evening, still clear to partly cloudy. Tonight looks warm and humid. May not get much below 80 degrees by morning, upper 70s or so. And then tomorrow, kind of the same thing. Hot again. We might see a heat advisory for parts of the valley. There's still enough moisture. You could say maybe there's one or two little showers somewhere, but future track shows almost nothing. I think maybe by the time we get to Wednesday and beyond, the moisture levels and maybe the instability comes up just a bit more. So you notice on future track on Wednesday, it does show more numerous showers trying to pop up. It may not be this widespread, but I think instead of a little speck on the radar here and there, maybe a couple of slightly larger showers or a weak thunderstorm could form. So rain chances, 20% today. That might even be a bit on the high side, at least 10% or so. And the same tomorrow, and then maybe getting a little bump by Wednesday and Thursday, and even slightly higher by the weekend. So with the added puffy clouds and rain chances, we may turn temperatures down just a few degrees later this week. But 99 today for an average, mostly sunny skies, a small chance of a shower. And then by tonight, down to 79, clear to partly cloudy. And the first 1-5 AccuWeather 7-day forecast. Again, temperatures about 99 or 100 or so the next few days. Today and tomorrow. By Wednesday, a little more moisture, maybe a spotty shower or thunderstorm, and temperatures go down maybe a degree or two in some areas, highs in the mid to upper 90s as we go into the weekend coming up. And by the weekend, some of the models, you know, not clearly agreeing on it, but with maybe a little more moisture in the air instead of like a 10 or 20% chance for rain like we have early this week, maybe getting up to like 30, 40%, especially by the weekend. So could turn up the rain chances just a bit, but not everyone getting rain. But we'll keep tracking in your first 1-5 forecast here on Channel 5 News at noon.